okay, people know that I am not a big fan of the governor. Chris Christie's second term is coming to an end soon. There will be a new governor come January. Christie's approval ratings are about as low as you can go. A lot of people in New Jersey, especially here in Atlantic City, are unhappy with him. He's very unpopular. What does the finance guru, do you have any thoughts about Christie's tenure as governor?
I was out of politics for a while, King, going back some time. And then Chris Christie came along running for governor. And I listened to what he had to say, and I really liked it. And I said, this is somebody I think I can get behind. I thought John Corzine was an incredibly poor governor, and I don't know if Christie at the time had the chance to win, but he really spoke to me, and I decided to be a supporter, an ardent supporter, and I supported him for both his gubernatorial elections, and I also supported him on his presidential run. Now, I say all that in the vein of full disclosure, so I have gotten to know the governor personally, and I have found him to be passionate and caring, and he's always been willing to listen, whether he agreed with me or not. As far as beyond being governor, I know that he's a devoted family man. His wife, Mary Pat, is absolutely wonderful. I think they've done a fantastic job raising their children in the public eye, which is not easy to do. But that aside, I haven't always agreed with the governor, but I've never doubted his intentions. I'm sure he'd like to have some do-overs, and who wouldn't? But you can't always agree with somebody who's in political office, King. It's just not going to happen. The only person I agree with all the time is myself, and sometimes not even then. So I think, related overall to what Governor Christie has done, I actually think he has done a good job. I think he has done good things for New Jersey. I know he's unpopular right now, and I know what I'm saying. Based on the approval ratings, most people are going to disagree with me. But I think the media has been incredibly unfair to him, and they're not going to give him credit for anything that he's accomplished. And keep in mind, it's really hard in New Jersey, a blue state, being a Republican governor. You have a Democratic legislature, and in order to really accomplish anything, you have to compromise. So you can't really, the governor can't really get through everything he wants to do. It's got to be compromised or watered down. I think if Chris Christie had a Republican legislature, we could have really seen what progress he could have made. But based upon the lay of the land, I don't think it's a good barometer of what he was really capable of doing. And I can't cover all the issues here, but I just want to highlight a few things that I think are important to mention about the governor. Look, he vetoed a lot of tax increases that were coming out of the legislature. He had a balanced budget every year. He got rid of the estate tax. And quite frankly, he contributed more to the pension than any of his predecessors. So look, the bottom line is this. True, he's unpopular, but I think history is going to treat him better than the way he's been treated right now. Now, if Phil Murphy's elected the next governor, a Democrat, and he's going to have a Democratic legislature, I think that he's going to be able to make a lot of changes. And one of those things that he's going to change is we're going to have tax increases. And he's talking about taxing the rich. It's going to go beyond that. It has to. So let's see how he does. And I think years from now, we're going to have a much clearer picture of what Chris Christie did and what his report card should be. And I think based upon who may very well become the next governor, there's going to be a clear distinction about what Chris Christie's policies were versus what presumably is going to be a complete 100% Democratic agenda.